Parkins's experience on this occasion was a very distressing one. He found that the picture which presented itself to him was continuous. When he opened his eyes, of course it went, but when he shut them once more, it framed itself afresh, and acted itself out again, neither quicker nor slower than before. What he saw was this: a long stretch of shore, shingle edged by sand, and intersected at short intervals with black groins running down to the water, a scene, in fact, so like that of his afternoon's walk that, in the absence of any landmark, it could not be distinguished therefrom. The light was obscure, conveying an impression of gathering storm, late winter evening, and slight cold rain. On this bleak stage, at first, no actor was visible. Then, in the distance, a bobbing black object appeared. A moment more, and it was a man running, jumping, clambering over the groins, and every few seconds looking eagerly back. The nearer he came, the more obvious it was that he was not only anxious, but even terribly frightened, though his face was not to be distinguished. He was, moreover, almost at the end of his strength. On he came. Each successive obstacle seemed to cause him more difficulty than the last. "Will he get over this next one?" thought Parkins. "It seems a little higher than the others." Yes, half climbing, half throwing himself, he did get over, and fell all in a heap on the other side, the side nearest to the spectator. There, as if really unable to get up again, he remained crouching under the groin, looking up in an attitude of painful anxiety. So far, no cause whatever for the fear of the runner had been shown. But now there began to be seen, far up the shore, a little flicker of something light-coloured, moving to and fro with great swiftness and irregularity. Rapidly growing larger, it too declared itself as a figure in pale, fluttering draperies, ill-defined. There was something about its motion which made Parkins very unwilling to see it at close quarters. It would stop, raise arms, bow itself toward the sand, then run stooping across the beach to the water edge and back again, and then, rising upright, once more continue its course forward at a speed that was startling and terrifying. The moment came when the pursuer was hovering about from left to right only a few yards beyond the groin where the runner lay in hiding. After two or three ineffectual castings hither and thither, it came to a stop, stood upright with arms raised high, and then darted straight forward towards the groin.